This is a project that we started about 3 or 4 years ago. In this project, we brought together a cohort of close to 300 tumor samples from lower grade glioma patients. And we then performed extensive molecular characterization on those, each of those tumor samples. So we did expression profiling, DNA copy number profiling, exome sequencing, and a few more. We then started analyzing the data, searching for subtypes in that data set of 300 samples. Can we bring groups of patients together that are similar to each other, and that may have clinical implications? So we did what is called unsupervised analysis, and with that unsupervised analysis we found more or less the same pattern in every data type we analyzed. And those pointed towards three groups, three types of lower grade glioma. So currently we distinguish astrocytoma, oligodendroglioma, and oligoastrocytoma. And we use grade 2, grade 3, grade 4 for these categories. In our analysis, we found three groups that had a lot of similarity between them, but the three groups were very different. So within group, the patients were very similar, but the three groups were very different to each other. And we think these three groups are important because they share disease biology, which means that, for example, in clinical trials, you might get a clearer answer to your question if you stratify cases by the three groups. A good example is a study known as RTOG 9802. In this clinical trial, there was sort of a significant survival difference between two arms, but only after 2 years. And we think, for example, that's a clinical trial where if you would use our stratification, you would see a result much sooner. Probably the most important aspect of this project is that we found a group that is wild type for a gene named IDH. And the outcome and the similarities of these patients are very much like glioblastomas. And even though these cases are classified as lower grade glioma, they're really glioblastomas and they should be treated as a glioblastoma.